Well, for the second year, the Cincinnati Zoo has unveiled the Rain Barrel Project.
Yeah, this is a partnership between the zoo and a local conservation group. WLWT News 5's Christy Davis has a look at how this is just one of their many efforts to conserve.
Well, it looks like we may have a pretty good day for the unveiling of the rain barrels, but the folks at the zoo say rain isn't the only thing these barrels save. The barrels themselves are a labor of love by local students.
We really wanted to stick with the peacock and have the tail kind of flowing into the river, showing how it conserves the water.
And they have a pretty practical application.
But doing it in Midwest style, we actually did it to help save money.
The zoo won't keep these, but it has invested about $2 million into giant rain barrels under the Africa exhibit. Over the last 7 years, they've saved $5.6 million and cut water consumption by 75%.
And it debunks what used to be a myth. The myth was, oh, we can't afford to go green. We can't afford to put in new systems that'll save water and energy.
Water is just a drop in the bucket when it comes to zoo conservation. It's also trying to become one of only a few zoos in the country to have a facility certified as a living building, meaning the structure wastes nothing. It will house the African painted dogs exhibit when it's done in June. And maybe you've seen the solar panels pointing towards the sky, the largest urban solar array in the country. But Dane Maynard says even the little projects go a long way.
We used to send our animal poop and leftover hay and straw to the landfill, and now we compost it instead at the same cost.
Another reason why Cincinnati Zoo is known as the greenest zoo in America, and ideas organizers hope catch on.
I think everyone should have a rain barrel. It really helped the environment.
Now, if you're interested in a rain barrel of your own, you can actually get your hands on one of these at the end of the month when they're auctioned off. From the zoo, Christy Davis, WLWZ News 5.
The proceeds from that auction will go toward environmental education. You can find out more about the auction on our website, WLWT.com.